A lot of teams have shaken things up this offseason, as they do pretty much every other offseason, and with there being a surprise team in the league pretty much every year, like the New York Knicks last year, the Grizzlies before them, and so on, I thought it would be fun to try and predict what would be the surprise team of the 2022 season. And ironically, the team that I picked for this year is one of the biggest sources of dread and disappointment in the NBA, the Minnesota Timberwolves. The Wolves have only made the playoffs once in the last decade, and that was only because of Jimmy Butler carrying them, and they're not a team that's particularly wise to invest in as a result. However, here I am doing exactly that. I think the 2022 season will be the year where the Timberwolves finally step up and are a respectable NBA team. Before I continue on with this video, about half of the people that watch these videos are not subscribed, so if you fall into that 50%, then please subscribe. Also, drop a like on this video. It only takes 1 second and makes a massive difference. I am less than 20k subscribers away from 200k now, so if you could subscribe, that'd be much appreciated. Let's look at Minnesota's depth chart. At point, we have D'Angelo Russell, Malik Beasley at the 2, Anthony Edwards at the 3, Jaden McDaniels at power forward, and obviously Cat at the 5. Off of the bench, they have Patrick Beverley, Jalen Noel, Josh Okogie, Torian Prince, and Naz Reid. Now, first things first, this doesn't really fit in the video, so I'm just going to do it right here. I want to dedicate a little segment to who is, in my opinion, perhaps the most underrated young player in the NBA, who is starting at the 4, in my rotation anyways, and that is Jaden McDaniels. Last year, Jaden was pretty much the perfect 4 to put next to Cat. He is a solid 3-point shooter, a great transition athlete and cutter, and a really, really, really solid defensive player. He's a good weak side shot blocker, averaging 1 block a game and around 20 minutes, and just really good at switching. He can't defend big post players because he's pretty scrawny, but other than that, he can hold his own against just about everyone. I really think he is the best option in the starting lineup, and I hope that Minnesota's head coach agrees. Anyways, I do want to add one caveat before I start praising and gassing up this team. The one reason why I believe the Timberwolves, or not the one, but the main reason I believe the Timberwolves can be really good next year, is if they just happen to get a stroke of luck for the first time in many years. Because they have needed injury luck for a long time and have gotten quite the opposite. Injury has been the main reason for their failures over the last 2 or 3 seasons. Cat missed 22 games last year, D'Lo missed 30 games and was injured in a lot of the games that he did play, averaging just 28 minutes a game as a result. And Malik Beasley missed 35 games, though that was because of off of the court stuff, not injury. So one of the reasons that I'm willing to bet on this team is that just if they get a year of relative health, that alone is going to make a wild difference from what they were in the 2021 season. After that, there are 4 main reasons why I believe the Wolves could be a lot better next year. 1. Anthony Edwards. 2. Karl-Anthony Towns and D'Angelo Russell and how good they are together. 3. Hopefully more of a focus on defense. And 4. Depth. Let's talk about Ant-Man first. The number one reason I'm willing to bet on the Wolves next year is that I expect a good amount from Edwards, and none of what I expect I feel is unrealistic. Let me put this in the simplest terms possible. Edwards in the first half of the season was a completely different player from who he was in the second half, and if he can be who he was in the second for the entirety of this year, which I think is completely reasonable, while taking some strides as a defender and decision maker, then I think Edwards can be a borderline all-star this season. In the first 36 games of the 2021 season, Anthony Edwards averaged 15 points on 47% true shooting. He averaged as many points per game as he did field goal attempts. But in the last 36 games, he averaged 23.8 points on 58% true shooting, averaging 24 a game on a little bit above league average efficiency, just a completely different player. He also shot 35% from 3 on 8 attempts a game in comparison to the 30% on 6 in the first half. He was playing like a scrub to start, and then he closed the season playing like an all-star. A full season of this Anthony Edwards, and not first half of last season Anthony Edwards, is going to make a world of difference. If he can do that while cleaning up his shot selection and being a respectable defensive player, then he is going to be essentially an all-star talent for this team for a full year. Reason 2 that I'm betting on the Wolves is that Karl-Anthony Towns and D'Angelo Russell are really good when they actually play together, Let me explain. Those two have barely played together due to a lot of their injury issues. It seems like when Kat is healthy, D'Lo is injured, and when D'Lo is healthy, Kat is injured. But in the 23 games they did play together, they have a 13-10 record. Among those wins, they beat the Utah Jazz 3 times, the Miami Heat, and the Dallas Mavericks. Now, they did mostly beat up on not particularly great teams, but still, that sets them apart from those not great teams because they were previously also not great, so at the very least, they're among the best of the not great teams in that circumstance. Essentially, the Timberwolves are an above 500 team when both of their two best players actually play. And that alone gives me confidence that if they can just be healthy, they can be a respectable NBA team, but then add Anthony Edwards playing like an all-star for a full season, and that makes me even more confident. The next factor is I think the Wolves could potentially be a passable defensive team. I think a full season of Jaden McDaniels at the 4 would benefit their defense quite a bit, especially if he makes a jump defensively. Anthony Edwards was closer to a neutral defender than a bad one last year. His on-ball defense is fine, and his off-ball defense is awful, but if he could at least be neutral, that'd be fine. Kat, at this point, is a relatively neutral defender. He has a reputation for being terrible, but over the past few years, he's gotten to the point of not being terrible. He's just fine. Now, D'Angelo Russell is tragically bad on defense, and Malik Beasley isn't too far from tragically bad himself. So, from the starting lineup, there are 2 passable defenders, 1 really good one, and 2 god-awful ones. But it is the bench lineup that I think can save their defense a bit, and that also kind of brings us onto the 4th thing, the 3rd thing. Hopefully better defense and the bench kind of overlaps here. But I actually really like Patrick Beverley on this team. His defense and hustle, I hope, will go beyond himself and be somewhat contagious on this team. If he's putting in effort on that end, it could make the rest of the team at least semi-care about defense. That would make a world of difference. Not to the point where it's going to make them a good defensive team or anything, but honestly, if Beverley can just spike up the effort by 15%, the team could be like, I don't know, the 20th best defense in the league, which isn't good, but it's much better than bottom 3. Beverley will get in his teammates' ears about defense, and then on top of that, off of the bench, they have Josh Okogie, who is a good defender, Torian Prince, who is solid on defense, and Naz Reid, who is more or less neutral. There's enough here to, at the very least, not be a bottom 3 defense in the NBA as they were last year. And as for the bench offense, Patrick Beverley is a capable spot shooter, and I actually would not be surprised if he overtook Malik Beasley in the starting lineup just for the sake of getting more defense with their starters and Beasley being a 6th man. Jalen Noel is an underrated player who has shown flashes of being a borderline elite 3-point shooter, but he's been so inconsistent that you can't quite give him that token yet. Josh Okogie is a god-awful offensive player, but worth playing for his defense. Torian Prince is a good 3-and-D player, and Naz Reid is a pretty damn solid scoring big, though I do feel he is a tad redundant on this team with Kat, and I wouldn't hate seeing him traded for a more defensive-minded big. Malik Beasley is another player that if he was traded for a more defensive-minded guy would certainly not be the end of the world, as much as I love his shooting. But looking at this roster as a whole, this is definitely a team that can be damn good on offense. The Wolves have 4 players in their starting lineup who averaged close to 20 or more last year. Now, of course, they won't average that together with all 4 of them healthy, but that does properly showcase the offensive talent and capability on this team. D'Lo's outside shooting, mid-range shots, and playmaking. Malik Beasley being one of the best shooters in the NBA. Anthony Edwards being a great slasher and a progressing shot creator. And Kat being one of the most well-rounded scoring bigs in the history of the game. If this team can just remain healthy, they are good enough offensively and hopefully passable enough defensively that they could make a push for the 8th seed in the Western Conference, or at the very least, make a play-in spot. Late in the 2021 season, the Wolves went on a 4-game win streak with D'Lo, Ant, and Kat all playing together, and I think that was a flash of what this team is capable of. The Wolves next year, I could very easily see being better than the Sacramento Kings, the Pelicans, the Spurs, and the Grizzlies. They just need health. That being said, I made a video in the not-so-recent past about how the Timberwolves are essentially cursed, and no matter what they do, they always seem to do it wrong, so I wouldn't put all my chips on them, but I'm also willing to put a bet on them to some extent. I would not be surprised at all if the Minnesota Timberwolves next year are not one of the worst teams in the league and even a playoff team. Again, all contingent on health. But shout out to Rudy for editing this video. That is the end of this video. Please be sure to like and subscribe for more NBA content like this. And cue the outro music.